My eyes hurt. Why?
No, it's just bright.
Do you want to help with your tablet?
No.
Hey guys, so today I'm here with Libby. We haven't actually filmed, well, we actually did film the other day, but you won't have seen that. So you won't have seen us on camera for ages.
Yeah,
together. On our channels, being ourselves. So it's kind of crazy.
It's kind of a bit weird, kind of a bit nervous.
Not sure what to expect, but we actually just did film like 3 videos, so we feel normal, right?
Yeah.
We have hula hoops, and
I've eaten one. Was I supposed to save them?
Oh, no. It's fine.
I can show yours.
Yeah, you know, that's not going to happen. Today, we're going to be doing a boy talk. I asked on Instagram for some scenarios that you guys are struggling with and want some advice.
Yeah.
We'll try and help.
We both have boyfriends who are so experienced in everything. So, yeah, we're basically your relationship gods.
Yeah. No, we
actually
don't know what we're doing.
Basically, you guys will send in scenarios. We're going to try our best to help you.
Yeah.
Hopefully, you guys are going to enjoy this. Also, we filmed a video over on my channel as well.
It was actually really deep, didn't it?
Yeah, but I liked it. Did you like it?
Yeah, I liked it.
Yeah, we just kind of talked about like pressures of being online as like a social influencer. That's kind of disgusting. Yeah, link in bio, first link, and on her YouTube, and in her banner, and on her profile.
But yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and comment down below what other videos you want me to do with Libby.
Yeah!
Subscribe and turn on post notifications and yeah, let's get on with the video! Okay, so the first one is, this is my boy scenario. So basically, I like this boy and we've been texting a while, but he showed me his best friend list on Snapchat and it's full of girls. I'm on there, but I'm not at the top. His ex is
at the top
and I don't know whether to trust him or not. Wow. My boyfriend's ex is the top of his Snapchat.
Yeah, though boys can be friends with girls and not like
his ex.
I just but I'm just saying in general, before we start the video, I think a lot of people have these like preconceived
if
like ideas.
Let me be friends with boys, that would be so
well that's
odd.
Really like that's a really bad relationship.
Really toxic.
Yeah.
It's
really bad. Anyway, sorry, back to the actual question, but I just wanted to say, like...
Yeah, so maybe he has... But if she doesn't know the girls...
Yeah, okay.
Then... But surely, because if the girls were his friends, she'd, like, know them and they'd get along well, hopefully.
Yeah.
But if they're just, like, random girls... Like, I know a lot of boys talk to, like, loads of girls, so girls that aren't necessarily his
also,
friends.
Also, I think it depends what terms their ex and him are on. Say they, like, they're kind of still, like, flirty and, like, all of that stuff.
Oh, my God.
That's different to whether they're just like, right, well, we were really good friends before, why can't we be friends afterwards? Because I feel like some people are like that and there's no romantic feelings at all. So if you're feeling like threatened, I don't know, if you're not, she's not dating him though.
Is she not?
No, she's talking to this boy. So it's different.
Is he the boy for you? If he's talking to
you? Yeah, if you're just talking to him.
Oh, I thought they were dating.
No, you can't really say, well, you're not allowed to talk to them.
Yeah, but when I was at a stage with my boyfriend where I was talking to him and like, if he was to talk to anyone else, that would be really bad. Like,
well, yeah, but
you know,
it's like,
if it's like the first, like, it depends because my boyfriend's not that kind of person that talks to like those girls.
No.
But like some boys are, and that's just like how their personality is, and then they don't really have bad intentions, but then some boys do.
So I think, carry on how you are, see how it goes. If he's showing signs that he's interested, say like, are we talking? Like talk, because this stage is like talking, you're a thing, you know, you're not dating for a long time.
Yeah.
So see if he's on the same page, because you don't know if he's just being friendly. See that you're on the same page, and then if you actually get to like a thing, then kind of say like,
I don't really feel comfortable. If you're friends with them, then that's fine. But if it's like, if you're talking to them the same level that you are to me, I'm not happy with that, and
don't
say bye.
Yeah, just be like, I don't think it'll work because like
I can do that.
I'm not talking to other people. Yeah.
If he was friends with them, that's fine. But like, if he was like talking to them, it'd be really odd.
Yeah, talking to them as in flirting with them and stuff like that. So just see what level you're on.
Maybe like hack his phone and like see what.
Do not do that at all.
So this girl says, I'm in a group with just girls, no boys whatsoever. And because there are no boys in our group, we feel unconfident around them and it's so annoying. Like if one of us likes someone, we will not do anything about it because they're not confident basically. And she asks, would you suggest talking to the boys online and stuff like that or trying to build up relationships offline and just facing up to them? I think the main thing is we're scared of rejection. So how do you know if someone is interested in you?
I have something to say, okay. Right. Something that I've experienced, more friendship, because kind of boys as well, but I didn't really talk to loads of boys, like, before my boyfriend. You talk online a lot, And then when you see them in person, a lot of the time it can be awkward because you're talking so much online, and then you're actually in person, it's kind of more pressure. Because when you're online, you can just like wait, send a message, think about what you're going to say. Do you know what I mean? If you don't want to talk, you don't have to open it.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas in person, it can be kind of, have you ever had that? It's kind of a bit awkward because you're more like online friends. So I would say definitely face-to-face is a lot better.
Yeah,
like,
I'd rather start a relationship face-to-face than online.
Definitely, because otherwise it becomes will become awkward, whereas...
Like, you've been talking to someone for like 4 months and you meet them in real life and like, it's not the same chemistry.
Yeah, exactly. So you just got to be brave, like the thing is...
But I get what she means, because my throughout like year 7 to year 11 in, what's it, secondary school?
Yeah.
My group of friends didn't have boys in it.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
only starting college that I have friends that are boys. But like before that, me and my friendship group didn't have... Boy,
yeah,
we didn't have boys in our group. However, like I feel like in lessons and stuff, like we had like a seating plan and our shoes always sat.
Mm.
So like we were always put next to boys and stuff.
Yeah,
but, like I wasn't friends with them. But I think a good thing to do is maybe join like clubs. Because me and my boyfriend met through doing this thingy at school, and we wouldn't have met otherwise. Apart from we obviously knew each other before, like we sort of like mutual friends, but like we wouldn't have become closer.
Yeah,
because
no,
if you're working with someone together, then it's not awkward because you can talk about that
and get
and
more,
like, that's an excuse to talk about them, and then you can obviously like talk about
others. Try to get more like comfortable in general with boys, because I can understand, like I don't know personally, like I don't know, because I went to like a mixed school, so did you as well. I was kind of like all right around boys, like I wasn't like ooh, like scared, but like get that confidence like on a friendship level first with boys, like establish it, because then they're no different to girls, like it's not like
I prefer talking to
boys are
sometimes.
A lot easier to talk to than
a lot easier
well.
To make friends with, like all the people that we've made friends with from like being stranger to stranger have been boys.
Yeah,
like have we made a friend that's
we boys are just a lot more approachable, I think.
Oh,
whereas
yeah,
girls would be like, why are you talking to me?
Yeah,
but yeah, like make sure you're like kind of comfortable, and also like fear of being rejected, like I know you may find it embarrassing for a day, but no one's gonna remember it and no one's gonna care and be like, oh, you got rejected. Do you know what I mean? Like it's gonna be old news, like no one's gonna really care.
And if they're nice boys that you're talking to, which you should be aiming to talk to, they're not gonna be like, I can't imagine, I'm picturing a nice boy in my school.
We're doing the same thing.
They wouldn't like make a big deal out of it.
Yeah.
This boy is really nice when I chat to him, but when he is talking to other girls, he says rude things about me. Which side of him is fake?
Sometimes boys will like show off in front of friends, but that's not okay.
I hate that.
I'm saying the truth, but
it's
not okay.
No, but they show off to their friends, but they shouldn't be bad about you.
Yeah.
Like, if they were like making fun of you, like imagine if your boyfriend, you found out he was making fun of you to your hip.
Is that her boyfriend?
Oh wait, I can't remember. No, maybe, was it just a boy that she liked?
Yeah.
Oh, it's hard because sometimes they're...
Boys definitely show off, like, it's I mean, so can girls as well. We're not, like, stereotyping, but boys have a tendency to be like, oh, I didn't even like that girl I'm talking to, whatever.
Yeah.
So he's probably trying to act, like, big in front of all these other girls. I just spat. But, like, not saying that that's acceptable.
No.
Maybe, so...
Does he have, like, an ex or like people that like maybe try and get other people's opinions on him,
yeah,
like what he's done
yeah,
before,
yeah, see what he's actually like,
yeah, because honestly,
what
like
think of him?
If I found out that like when I was talking, before I was talking to Joe, that he was like making fun of me to his friends, even though he's making fun of me anyway,
did he? Oh my god, wait, that's so funny though, because me and Flynn hated each other.
Me and Joe have been in the same classes throughout year 7 to year 11. But, like, he would make fun of me for my YouTube.
No way, because literally Flynn, like, we didn't hate each other. He used to always make fun of me. Like, he didn't like me at all.
Yeah.
And I didn't like him, so I was like, he's so mean. That is
so
funny.
Apparently
though,
apparently it's because he didn't know what else to talk to me about.
Oh, no,
I
don't
know if
I believe
him.
Hmm? Flynn just didn't like me, and I just didn't like him.
Oh.
And then he loved me. What is this? Look at my hair.
Yeah, you look cool. I feel like we didn't answer that very well, but I'll move on. This girl sits next to this boy in maths. He's in most of her lessons, except for two. And I told him I liked him and even asked him out, and he said no. A few weeks later, my crush for him came back, and now I don't know if he feels the same way. And I don't know how to face him in school tomorrow.
No.
She's in all the same lessons as him.
I think, I've said this before, I think I don't know how you can like a boy that doesn't like you.
Mm-hmm.
I'd feel personally, if I've liked a boy, and they don't like me, I don't know, if something in me like instantly turns off, because I'm like, well, why would I spend time on him when he doesn't actually like me? So you kind of, in the harshest way possible, got to get it in your head.
And you're gonna find someone that likes you back the same
yeah,
way.
Yeah, why would you want someone that really, really likes you? Yeah. So you're kind of in like a harsh way, you gotta get it in your head that he almost, you know, he doesn't like you in that way.
Yeah.
It's more friends. And just, but you'll wait and you'll find someone that really likes you just for like, put you up. So
yeah,
try your best to kind of put yourself off of him.
Yeah, I agree.
Do you think?
Yeah, I agree.
I wanna know if you're being my girl. Be my girl, baby.
So this girl's boyfriend cheated on her at a party and he kissed the other girl, made out with her. He's drunk though. Does she forgive him or dump him?
Okay, this one me and Evie always talk
okay,
about.
Okay, I actually read about this. And apparently when you're drunk, it forces you to do something that you really deeply wanted to do for a long time. So when you're drunk, if you kiss someone, it means that that's been building up and that's what you've actually been wanting to do for a long time. And it just gives you, when you're drunk, you just have the confidence to do what you actually really want to do inside.
Really?
I like fully read like a science thing about it.
Wow, that's...
that's the answer to the question.
Yeah, but then we always talk about it and we always say, yes, I would dump him immediately. But then it's like, how to get over it. Like, it's really hard.
Someone that I was with ever cheated on me, I would have to have like a break or like, I'd just...
yeah.
I'd have to be like...
You take a break.
Otherwise I think it's okay and I'll do it.
Make him work for it. I don't know. At the end of the day, we can't tell you what to do. Like, it's one of those things that's definitely just like your call. Like, whether you think it's worth...
or how long
getting back
together
with him. Yeah.
If you really, really loved him and he loved you.
But maybe if it's been like a week and you're dating, then... no.
I'd be so angry. I'd break up with him.
Yeah.
Like,
it's too much. I just don't think I personally could, like... be in a relationship when I know he's like kissed someone.
But you don't just go up to someone and like kiss them, like it's a mutual thing.
You've got to work towards it.
You've got to work towards it, you've got to think about it, you've got to actually kiss them, and that whole time, if they've done that without thinking once about you and they've still gone through with it, then obviously they're not the right person. That's
what I think. Oh, 100%
not. Like, because you must think about your girlfriend before doing that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I have a girlfriend. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. Bye, guys.
Bye. Thank you guys for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. We hope you got some good advice from this.
And yeah, hopefully
if you actually had your scenario answered, then let us know what happens.
Yeah,
I hope we haven't ruined your relationship.
Yeah. Also, if you guys do want to see the video that me and Evie filmed, it'll be linked below. It's super nice. Like,
it was like a positive chat on the channel. So check that out. Subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, and turn on post notifications. And yeah, I'll see you in my next video.
Bye, guys. Oh, baby, I love your madness. It's so.